So up to now, we have studied about the planes which have maximum normal stress, and the corresponding maximum normal stress is called principal stress, and the shear stress on the principal planes is zero. If I concentrate on the equation for shear stress for a complex system, so there must exist the planes on which the value of shear stress is maximum. So to finding out the maximum value of tau, I have to differentiate it with respect to theta. So I get minus sigma x sigma y cos 2 theta minus 2 tau sine 2 theta. So when I equate it to 0, I get tan 2 theta is equal to minus sigma x minus sigma y divided by 2 tau. So this indicates that there are two values of 2 theta, again differing by 180 degree, and the theta that is differing by 90 degree. So thus maximum shear stress planes lie at right angle to each other. So in a very similar analysis as we did for the principal stresses, so from tan 2 theta, if I find out the value of sine 2 theta from the triangle, minus sigma x minus sigma y 2 tau. So here is the hypotenuse. So from here I can get the value of sine 2 theta. And cos 2 theta is equal to plus minus 2 tau root of sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus 4 tau square. So now you can see that we have opposite signs. So when I if I use negative here, then I will consider positive of cos 2 theta. So when I put it in the equation for tau theta, I get tau theta is equal to minus plus 1 by 2 sigma x minus sigma y sigma x minus sigma y divided by sigma x minus sigma y square plus 4 tau square plus minus tau 2 tau sigma x minus sigma y square plus 4 tau square. So I get plus minus 1 by 2 sigma x minus sigma y whole square plus 4 times tau square. So this is tau theta maximum, and this is also equal to half of sigma 1 minus sigma 2. Thus, in general, I can write that tau maximum is equal to 1 by 2 sigma 1 minus sigma 2 is equal to 1 by 2 sigma x minus sigma y square plus 4 tau square. So it can also be seen that if I compare the position of planes of maximum normal stress, that is tan 2 theta is equal to 2 tau sigma x minus sigma y, with the position of maximum shear stress, that is sigma x minus sigma y by 2 tau. So if I multiply them, then I can get the product as minus 1, which means that the angle between 2 theta, that is theta for maximum normal stress, and 2 theta shear is 90 degree. So I can conclude that the planes of maximum shear stress lie at 45 degree to the planes of principal stresses. So these analyses are made from the small element. So there is another method that is called the geometrical construction method for finding out the principal stresses and maximum shear stresses and the position of principal planes. So we will discuss that method in the next lecture.